can't hold them accountable if we don't have a newspaper.
Nixon will muster the full power of the presidency, and if there's a way to destroy you, by God, he'll find it.
I'm asking your advice, Bob, not your permission.
But you can't do this.
The legacy of the company is at stake.
What will happen if we don't publish? We will lose. The country will lose.
What are you going to do, Mrs. Graham?
Hello, once again, watchers of Good Movies. My name is Nick Pell, and this is my review of The Post. If you're curious why I'm reviewing this film now when it came out a couple weeks back or over a month back or something, I am trying to review all the Oscar-nominated Best Picture films that I have not yet seen and reviewed on this channel, which is the majority of them. So over the next couple days, I'll be going out and trying to catch all those films. So that would include, obviously, The Post for this review. The Shape of Water, which would probably come out Friday. Saturday, I'm going to try to see Darkest Hour and Phantom Thread. And then Sunday, I'll see Call Me By Your Name and Dunkirk. I also saw Three Billboards a couple months ago. I didn't do a review on it because I wasn't really doing active reviews at the time. But I'll try to do a review from memory at some point. So I have all 8 of them covered, or however many there are. Let's talk about The Post. The Post takes place in 1971. It deals with a person who has access to top secret documents about the Vietnam War, basically showcasing that the government and the presidents from the start of the war to the present day have been basically lying about how well we're doing in the war and the need for more troops and things like that, when they know that it's actually been going very, very badly. And that we've basically been losing for a number of years now, and yet they continue to send more and more troops in, basically to stop the insult or the devastation that would be to America that we lost a war. So these documents, they get leaked. They are basically copied and printed, because that's what you had to do in the olden days. They get sent to the New York Times. New York Times starts to print these pages off. They get in trouble with the court. They get stopped. So it falls on the Washington Post, which is run by Tom Hanks and Meryl Streep's characters, to decide whether or not they want to take the chance to run these documents once they get their hands on them. Now, this probably goes without saying, but I'll mention it anyway. Tom Hanks and Meryl Streep, they give really good performances in this film. I really enjoyed them. Meryl Streep is this woman who feels very out of place. She has basically inherited this company, which was ultimately run by her father, which is given it to her husband. Her husband died, and then she basically took over. And so she feels kind of out of place. She's not really sure how to make any of the major decisions. She's not very comfortable with that at the beginning of the film. And so it's really interesting to see her character and trying to make decisions regarding the paper, whether they have to take it public, put stocks in it, and allow other people to invest in it and own the company. And then on the other side of things, we have Tom Hanks, who is the editor-in-chief of the Washington Post, and he is basically just trying to get a story out, because at the time, apparently, I wasn't aware of this, the Washington Post was a very small organization, and they weren't nearly the behemoth that they are today, along the lines of New York Times and other major newspapers. So when these Vietnam files fall into his hands, he has to make a decision in regards to the law and freedom of the press and all that good stuff. And the major thing that you've probably heard about this film is that the main focus that it deals with is the idea of freedom of the press. What can the press print, and what can the government stop it from printing? And this is a huge issue which goes throughout the film, because like I mentioned, the New York Times originally has these documents, they're printing them day by day, and then eventually they are stopped by the government through a judicial court, basically telling them you can no longer print these documents or else you're going to go to prison, essentially. And so it really deals with, again, like I said, what the newspapers are allowed to print and what is allowed in that regard. It's very relatable to today, because you have obviously a lot of things going around about fake news and news networks which are very biased or don't necessarily follow direct sources or things of that sort, or people will post on social media sources or links to things which don't have sources to back up the information, things of that sort. And so it's nice to see back into a time period where your sources mattered. You had to cite things, and you basically could not print anything unless you had sources to confirm that. And so it's just really interesting to see a look back at that time period. The movie is a little under 2 hours long, and it does kind of feel like it. The first two acts are very drawn out because you know roughly where the film is going to lead to. It's going to lead to eventually these papers being decided to be printed, and then the whole decision whether or not it's going to be justified or they're all going to go to prison. You can pretty much guess what's going to happen by the end of the film if you know the current state of the freedom of the press. That said, the third act, where we do get into the government proceedings and deciding what is going to ultimately happen to this group of people, is probably the most exciting part of the film because it is the most suspenseful and the most intense portion of it. That said, I would have liked to see a lot more of that stuff happening, or maybe even more goings on with the New York Times and what they're posting and behind the scenes of that aspect in regards to this type of stuff, because that would have been a little bit more interesting and would have been more relatable, not just strictly focused on the Washington Post. Because ultimately, I really just found this film to be, it's good, but it's not great, in my opinion. I don't think it's really Best Picture worthy. I really only think that it's being nominated, and it's really up here among the other movies that are being nominated because it's relevant to today. It has Tom Hanks and Meryl Streep in the main roles, and it came out in late December, when all the Oscar bait films generally do come out. I honestly think if this film had come out in February or March of 2016, we wouldn't be hearing a word about it, because I think it's just a generally good film, but it's not Oscar worthy, in my opinion. Because it really doesn't do anything radical, it doesn't really do anything which changes the genre of film or anything like that. It just tells the story, and that's it. And again, while it's relevant, I don't know if this is necessarily worthy of being a Best Picture nomination. But that said, it is, so obviously some people did enjoy it, but those are my thoughts on it. Let me know yours in the comments down below. Did you like the post more than I did? Did you like it less than I did? Let me know. Like, favorite, comment, and subscribe once again. If so, choose it. Appreciate it immensely. And as always, my people, my name is Nick Pell. And once again, keep on watching.